Hi, welcome back to Milio Guide. I'm Margaret Martin, and today I wanted to share with you a recent systematic review that looks at a whole bunch of studies, and this systematic review is specifically on the effects of training on bone mass with older adults. And older adults, which I guess I'm officially in that category, is 50 plus. And so in the systematic review, they take all the research articles that talk about individuals with osteoporosis, osteopenia, people that are at risk for low bone mass, and they go, what type of training best address the building of bone mass? And looking at all these studies, what is the conclusion? And so I'm always excited when I see large research reviews that support what Milio Guide does, and wanted to share that information with you. In case you do want to research it yourself, it is an article in Sports Medicine of April of 2012. So in the research study, there's two main categories of exercise. One is cardiovascular and the other is strength training. What the conclusion of the predominant conclusion of the studies of the cardiovascular was that things like comfortable walking, as we had indicated in a previous blog on walking, comfortable walking is not enough of a stimulus for our bones. But when we increase our walking pace and even make it multi-component, where we can incorporate some step climbing and a little bit of jogging, definitely brisk walking, all of those studies show that women, and I say women because there are very few studies on bone mass done on men, so sorry guys, but that women do build bone, even if it's incrementally, you know, 1-2%. Some studies where they did multiple types of cardiovascular, they had great numbers, like 5-6% increase. But the key here is even with a 1% increase, that's what we were getting with the study group. With the control group, meaning the people that weren't doing the cardiovascular exercise, they were losing bone at a rate of up to 5% in the same period of time. So when you look at the difference, and we know that that difference is building over time, that's really significant. So that's the first thing on cardiovascular. So let's now talk about the strength studies. And in the strength studies, what was shown was that you were able to build bone not just at the hip, which is what predominantly was shown in the aerobic studies, but also at the spine. Most of the studies were done using a DEXA, which is the most standard way of measuring bone density. But the key thing here is that the DEXAs, when they looked at studies using other forms of bone measurement, such as peripheral quantitative computer tomography, PQCT, they're going, wow, we can actually see changes in the PQCT, which were positive in terms of bone building, but that weren't actually seen on the DEXA. So that's an important component as well. So as I talked about earlier in terms of the aerobic exercise, the strength building exercises, the strength training done with enough intensity, was able to build bone, again, not at huge numbers, but it made the difference between not losing bone at huge numbers. And so people were actually able to not only maintain, but continue to build bone well into their 60s and 70s, which was really exciting to see. One other thing to bring up here is that they were looking specifically at men and women. Women, we know, they lose a lot of bone when they hit menopause, but they will continue losing bone well into their 60s, 70s, and 80s at a less of a quick rate than they did when during menopause. Men, however, comparing the rate of bone loss in their 70s compared to their 60s, men generally will start losing bone even as early as their 40s if they're not very active, and they'll continue losing bone. But men in this particular study, when they looked at men in their 70s versus their 60s, they were losing bone 2-4 times the rate. And so when you're looking at a active, pleasant retirement, that really is lost if you're having to deal with multiple fractures. And so I really encourage you to, if you are older yourself, to embark upon a safe strength training program or encourage your loved ones to do so. One last point to bring up in the studies that was looked at was that the benefits of the aerobic and the strength training did carry over into balance, and that in the studies showed that people that participated in the study also improved in their balance on significant measures. And so if you're wanting to follow a safe exercise program, the Mealy Guide program has been designed that follows the guidelines for aerobic strength training, and I also incorporate balance exercises as well. So that's it for today on Mealy Guide. Thanks for tuning in.